am a big fan of going early because, you know, if you don't get the shot, you can get a chance for an offensive rebound, but you lengthen the game. So if you don't convert, you can force Villanova to make free throws.
A resurgent rivalry, a classic back in the 80s. In particular, the 1985 national title game in Lexington with Georgetown met Villanova. Few gave Nova a chance. After all, the Hoyas had Patrick Ewing. But what a shooting night for Villanova. 22 of 28 and 9 of 10 in the second half. Only 10 shot attempts. Yet they win the game by two. Rolly Massimino getting the national title.
Each guy did their job. Eddie Pinckney was sensational on the backboard. Dwayne McClain slashing. There's the Worcester product in the national championship room. Dwayne McClain.
And Ed Pinckney, an assistant coach on Villanova's team.
So now you have a choice if you're Georgetown. Are you going to try to get that post-up look that you've gone to with Roy Hibbert? As you see Pinckney, now an assistant coach of Villanova. Do you go to the post-up, which you had success on one of two chances with Hibbert, or do you go to Green? There's a Green switch back on the post.
8 second difference between the game and shot clock. 13 to go. Here's Green off the bounce. Big shot by Jeff Green, and Georgetown has a 1 point lead, and we've got a timeout on the floor.
Terrific execution by Georgetown. They looked like they were going to set a little post up for Green, and instead he comes opposite the down screen by Hibbert. You see Nardi close out a little up fake under control. Nardi goes out to challenge. Just a smart play by Jeff Green. And the react. Yes, sir, we see you.
And an official's timeout to check how much time remains in the game. They want to make sure that they got it right when the ball went through the hoop. Villanova also called timeout, so no timeouts remaining for the Wildcats.
As soon as it goes through, it should stop. So 19.8, maybe 5/10 of a second they put back, if anything.
And then again, Villanova called its final timeout on the heels of that official timeout. So no timeouts remaining for them. One timeout for Georgetown. And don't forget, coming up next, Pittsburgh coming off that loss to Louisville, taking on Washington.
Well, uncharacteristically, Pittsburgh has been loose with the basketball in some of their losses this year. And that's just not Jamie Dixon basketball. They generally value the rock, take quality shots.
Now they're having an even bigger issue with the clock. It says 19:59, and as much as it might be fun to watch these teams go at it for another 20 minutes, I think 19 seconds will do. They're going to put, as you called, Doris, perfectly, half of a second back on there. So 19.8, Villanova will have the basketball out of timeouts.
And interestingly, put the timing situation in the hands of the officials. Each of those three guys has a device on their hip that allows them to start the clock. We saw a scoring error early, or a timing error early in a game at Duke.
What's the call here if you're Villanova? If you're Jay Wright, what are you drawing up?
Well, I mean, it's been a consistent theme, and even the last time these two teams played, and we saw it on the last possession, you ball screen. You're ball screening for Reynolds or Nardi. They're coming off looking to turn the corner. A pitch, if somebody closes, that help defender closes, and maybe a slash to the rim by Sumpter. It's been consistent. They have not deviated from it either today or in their past.
Villanova's also had some trouble getting a shot to the rim. 14 blocks for Georgetown in the game. Here's Reynolds playing with four personal fouls. 12 seconds to go. Reynolds taking it to the goal, lost it. No call as there was contact, and Villanova's going to keep possession with 9 seconds left.
He wanted the charge. They got Hibbert where they wanted him. They got Hibbert involved in a high ball screen.
Reynolds to inbound with 9.2 remaining. Again, Villanova out of timeouts. It goes to the corner. Clark missed the three. Summers with the rebound. And they foul Green with 3.6 left, and Green is hurt. Green rolled his ankle earlier in the game, and I think he just took a shot to the face there as Villanova was trying desperately to commit a foul.
looks like he just wants a moment to compose himself. The contest, it goes off long. Great pursuit on the weak side by Summers, who gives it up quickly. That's a dangerous pass. That will make you hold your breath if you're a coach. Pretty good look.
And then the freshman Summers turns and throws it right under his own basket, but no white shirts there. Thankfully for John Thompson's sake, and probably DeJuan Summers' sake.
That's about the last pass you wanted. It was like hot potato by Summers. And Summers had gone 1-for-2 from the free throw line, the last chance he had.
Jeff Green, a 78% free throw shooter, but 0-for-1 today. That's the 10th team foul by Villanova. So two free throws for Green. Villanova out of timeouts. Even if Green hits both, Villanova will have a chance. And keep in mind, we've already had one half-court shot at the end of the first half. Jesse Satt for Georgetown. Green cans the first one.
The next one is what changes the complexion, because you're forcing them to make the deep ball.
A career high 8 blocks for Jeff Green to go along with 18 points, and he's had some terrific passes as well, setting up his teammates.
And Franny Fischella talked about this. He told his guys, if you have 3 seconds, it generally means 3 dribbles before you have to get a shot here. Great piece on ESPN.
Got the second one. Villanova needs a three. 3.6 seconds left.
Where you catch the entry is huge.
Here's Reynolds. He got about 5 dribbles, and he got it away. And it is no good, and Georgetown hangs on. And the Hoyas win their 9th in a row, and they're tied with Pitt atop the Big East standings.
Typical Big East basketball this season. This conference is a meat grinder. And like the ACC, lots of last-second shots. Scotty Reynolds on the catch just goes.
He got about 6 or 7 dribbles and got a good look at the three.
Gets the jump stop down, leans into it. Almost would have been better served to just jump stop and go up with it.
Remember, Georgetown's had 14 blocks. And Reynolds was trying to elude Summers, who was flying in there. 58-55, Georgetown knocks off Villanova. 9 straight wins for the Hoyas. For Doris Burke, I'm Dave Pasch. Now to Sean McDonough, Pitt and Washington. Sean.
All right, Dave, thank you, and welcome everyone to the sold-out Peterson Event Center on the campus of the University of Pittsburgh. Our coverage presented by Cars.com. It is a non-conference matchup between the Pac-10 and the Big East. The Washington Huskies come 2,200 miles to the peak. They are 16-9. The Pittsburgh Panthers, ranked number 5, 22-4 overall. Sean McDonough with Bob Wenzel. Delighted to have you with us. Bob, great chance for Washington today. If the NCAA tournament field was picked today, they would not be in it with an RPI of 83. But like Louisville Monday night, if they come in here and get a win at Pittsburgh, a chance to really improve their resume.
No doubt about it, and they are motivated in that way. Pittsburgh, of course, like a wounded animal. They lose at home, and they're a good team. I think they will be very, very focused in this game.
Antonio Graves to LeVance Fields, the starting point guard. Now Mike Cook and into Levon Kendall. He scores. Same starting lineup that has started every game for Jamie Dixon. All 27 now has started the game again today for Pittsburgh. Aaron Gray, the 7-footer, the only one not to touch during that sequence. John Brockman out to Ryan Appleby, a good 3-point shooter. Brockman, the leading rebounder in the Pac-10 with the scoop, and Washington's even at 2.
Washington, 1 road victory the entire year at Arizona State. This would be huge for them.
Out of bounds, last touch by Justin Dentman.
You know, Sean, Spencer Hawes, their star center, the guy with the great reputation, freshman 7-footer coming in, had some illness and injury. And I think because of that, Washington has underachieved a tad bit from preseason expectations.
Well, he was sick. They started out 1-6 in Pac-10 conference play. Here's Aaron Gray, double-teamed, and his pass deflected by Ryan Appleby to Justin Dentman, the sophomore point guard. Appleby for 3. That's his game. 171 career field goals for Appleby, and 136 of them are threes.
He loves that three-point line. A transfer from the University of Florida. How about that?
Played 1 year for the Gators, then returned home to the state of Washington. Ryan Appleby from Stanwood, Washington. Levon Kendall also from the Pacific Northwest, Vancouver, British Columbia. And he found Antonio Graves in the corner for a three. Pittsburgh in their loss to Louisville Monday night by 13, their worst home loss in the five-year history of this building, went just 3-for-21 from beyond the three-point line. They're still the best three-point shooting team in the Big East at nearly 39%.
That game was an aberration for Pittsburgh. Throw it out, don't even worry about it.
Question is, how will they respond today? Nice pass by Appleby, and Levon Kendall blocked the shot of Justin Dentman, rescued right at midcourt by Quincy Pondexter, the freshman. His floater wouldn't go and tipped out of bounds by Aaron Gray. 20 NBA scouts here today, and a lot of them have come to see the 2 7-footers go head-to-head, two of the best big men in the country in Spencer Hawes and Aaron Gray.
The rookie Hawes and the veteran Gray, freshman and senior.
John Brockman, his miss rebounded by Levon Kendall, tied at 5. 2.5 minutes gone by here in Pittsburgh. It's just the third meeting ever between these two schools. Mike Cook missed a three, and Appleby the rebound. The other two meetings were both in Seattle in back-to-back days in 1950 when Pittsburgh made an 8-game West Coast road trip. Hawes missed from in close. LaVance fields the push with Cook. And the transfer from East Carolina gets it to drop and give Pittsburgh a 2-point lead.
When Pittsburgh gets out, when they play strong defense and can get out and get quality shots, that is the name of their game. Stay between your man and the basket on defense. Force the miss.
Appleby to Hawes, freshman, hometown product from Seattle. Tough fadeaway off the glass. Lorenzo Romar, his coach, says he is as skilled as any big man you will find. The ability to shoot with each hand, pass with each hand. As a matter of fact, Lorenzo compared Hawes' passing skills to Bill Walton, and that is the ultimate compliment for a passing big man.
High praise. His uncle Steve played 10 years in the NBA, Sean, and dad, Jeff, was also a star at the University of Washington, so good genetics.
Appleby, who was a point guard in high school, and now Quincy Pondexter, another highly touted freshman, came in this year along with Hawes. The young Washington team, they have a 10-man squad right now due to red shirts or injury. They're down to 10 healthy players, and 7 of the 10 are freshmen or sophomores. Graves did not connect with Gray, but Cook to the rescue. And Brockman the rebound. He's at 9.7 rebounds per game. You almost had it, but Dentman saved it instead right in front of us. Appleby might have gotten away with a travel, and he hits the floater. For Washington, a 2-point lead and 5 points for Ryan Appleby.
Well, Lorenzo Romar says that Washington is playing the best it has played all year right now, and they're going to need it here in this game. Terrific start for the guys from the West Coast. This is what you want on an away court.
Hawes, the block shot, is 41st of the year. That's the freshman record at the University of Washington. He broke Todd McCulloch's record. The Huskies come to Pittsburgh having won 5 of their last 7, but off a disappointing home loss Wednesday night to their arch rival, Washington State, with a close game that went down to the final buzzer. That was an opportunity missed for the Huskies, who really need wins against quality opponents down the stretch. Quincy Pondexter the foul and a timeout. 7-footer against 7-footer, and that time Hawes won the battle against Gray.
NCAA Women's Basketball Championship coming in March.
I've been to Newark, Hackensack, 3 meetings back-to-back.
Conference in Maine, put faces to names.
Seminar, Lombard, big stack of business cards.
Stayed at Comfort Suites, got a hot breakfast free.
Warehouse inventory, Foreman had a funny story.
Big meeting, New Rochelle, told my boss all went well.
Everywhere.
This
This spring, stay at any Comfort Inn, Comfort Suites, Quality Inn, Sleep Inn, or Clarion Hotel. You'll earn triple choice privileges points or triple airline rewards with your second stay. For reservations, visit choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there.
Introducing Optimum Voice World Call, the biggest breakthrough in international calling ever. One low monthly rate gives you the world. Say hey to your amigos in Colombia or in the Dominican Republic. Plan your vacation to France. Call your family in Mexico. It's the best way to stay in touch. Optimum Voice World Call, just $19.95 more a month. Saving has never been simpler. No special codes, no surprises on your monthly bill. Call 1-888-774-9377 today and say hello to the world. And we mean the world.
Hey, how do we offer 13 calling features at no extra charge like Optimum Voice?
We're working on it.
Susan, Optimum Voice World Call lets you call all over the world for one low monthly rate. What's our plan?
We're working on it.
How do we stop our customers from switching to Optimum Voice?
We're working on it. Hey, get me out of here.
We're working on it.
For the best value in phone service, starting at just $29.95 a month, it's Optimum or it's not.
Go.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Cars.com. Find the right car for you, Cars.com. And in part by Avis, we try harder.
Back in Pittsburgh, the Oakland Zoo getting fired up. They're not used to seeing a home loss as they did on Monday night, just the eighth loss in 5 years in this building for the Pitt Panthers. Meanwhile, Washington, a tough place to play on the road, really needs a win. We mentioned the RPI is 83, but great opportunity. Ordinarily, you wouldn't like to play this murderer's row, the schedule they have left, starting with Pittsburgh today, but when you need wins to get into the tournament, it's a great opportunity.
It's all in front of you, and look at the bottom of this graphic, the two Oregon schools away from home. The Southern California schools come calling at the end. The Pac-10 plays a round-robin schedule. Everybody plays everyone twice, unlike the Big East, where that does not happen, and some other leagues as well. And as a result, everybody gets the same opportunity. Lorenzo Romar was an outstanding player, and of course, in his fifth season here. How about their last 2 years, huh, Sean? 2 years ago, a number one seed in the NCAA tournament with Nate Robinson, and last year, Brandon Roy made it to the Sweet 16 both of those seasons.
In the NCAA tournament 3 years in a row. Trying to make it for a school record fourth consecutive year. Mike Cook leaves after shooting the free throws. And Keith Benjamin is off the bench. It's a nine-man rotation for Pittsburgh. They started the same five in every game, but Jamie Dixon says we have nine starters. They have an excellent bench of four. Sam Young also in off that bench, called for a blocking foul as he stepped into Adrian Oliver, who's come in for Washington. Jamie Dixon in his fourth season as head coach at Pittsburgh, now tied with Georgetown for the top spot in the Big East standings. Was this a non-league game today? But they have a very tough road left. Four games left in the Big East after today. We'll show you their schedule later. As well as Georgetown's playing, for a while it looked like Pittsburgh was in firm command of the Big East, Bob. Not so anymore.
Well, they tied with Georgetown, of course. Georgetown really on and one, run eight games in a row. Hibbert and Green are playing fabulously well together.
Adrian Oliver, another one of those freshmen. They had 2 points off the bench the entire game the other night against Washington State, both from Oliver. They are not very deep. Here's Oliver spotting up for a three that he rattles in. He averages five per game in 21 and a half minutes.
They like him shooting from the perimeter, although his numbers belie that he's not a good shooter at 27% from deep. This is a team that, whose core is Hawes and Brockman.
Ronald Ramon couldn't save the pass. Out of bounds, a turnover by Pittsburgh. That was another huge problem for them on Monday night against Louisville. They have 15 first half turnovers. They average 12 per game. No field goals now in more than 3 minutes for Pitt after they hit two of their first three shots. 0 for 4 since. Washington turned it back over. LaVance Fields, the sophomore, called for a walk by Michael Stevens. He's working with Mike Kitts and Bob Donato.
Trying a little bit too hard in this game because of these numbers in their last game. Well below their averages in all areas. You mentioned the big turnover story for Jamie Dixon, but this is an excellent team. And usually when you're an excellent team, you bounce back from performances like that one.
Appleby trying to lob it inside. And a foul before Brockman handled the pass. It's on Sam Young, so two quick fouls for the sophomore from Clinton, Maryland, just off the bench. Tyrell Biggs, the next to come in for Pittsburgh. And Artem Wallace, 6'8 sophomore, replaces Brockman for the University of Washington. Here's Wallace, who was born in St. Petersburg, Russia, came to the state of Washington as an exchange student in high school. He's double-teamed. Oliver, long with the two. But corralled by the smallest man on the court, Dentman. Seven minutes played, a four-point lead for Washington. Appleby's three, rebounded by Keith Benjamin. Antonio Graves, Wallace trying to defend him. Graves went by him, then missed the layup. And Pittsburgh will play it in with 20 seconds to shoot.
Confidence builds early in the game when you get a lead on the road like Washington has done. The only team non-conference to ever win in this building, Bucknell, 2 years ago. That team, of course, beat Kansas in the NCAA. So Washington trying to do something that has been a rare feat indeed.
Tyrell Biggs missed the foul line jumper. Now Dentman struggled a bit in this his sophomore season. Last year benefited from playing alongside Brandon Roy, the Pac-10 player of the year, averaged 20 points per game, could help bring the ball up if need be. This Roy was the sixth pick of the NBA draft. They lost three starters off their Sweet 16 team of a year ago. Still picked to finish third in the Pac-10 this year. Nice passing inside, Oliver to Wallace, and the lead grows. Bob, Lorenzo Romar said last night, given the departures, given how young this team is, the expectations were probably a little bit high. Right now they're seventh in the Pac-10, well below that projected third place finish.
Yeah, and you know, most people don't understand the effect of losing a guy like Roy, because he wasn't just a star player. He did everything for this team. His leadership was so, so important. But they're playing well now. This is a very, very impressive start. Very aggressive on defense. They've taken Gray out of the game. The inside guys have played very well.
They have indeed. Washington's on a 9-1 run over the last 5.5 minutes. Hawes highly touted for his passing by the coach, and there was a great example of it.
Vehicle listings to choose from on cars.com. You can find the right car for you.
Blue it is.
Find the right car for you. Cars.com.
Traffic ahead.
Incredible. You found a golf course near the conference. Awesome Chinese. Now you find me a way around traffic. I love you.
Turn around. Every now and then I get a little.
Street exit.
You're right. We'll just keep it professional, you know.
Go everywhere, find everything. Fall hard for the new Wear 2 GPS at Avis.
All right, international shipping. Well, your products are on a plane, ready to go to your customers in Europe to arrive on Friday. But Italy wants it there by noon, Paris early morning, and London late afternoon. Well, if you had a UPS logo, now when your customers ask, you can say, see, we. And yes, it's not international shipping. It's international shipping with UPS. And you even got a little tailwind.
Great day of college basketball on ESPN continues tonight. A battle for first place in the ACC as the North Carolina Tar Heels travel north to face Boston College. And a reminder, friends, the coverage begins with College Game Day, driven by State Farm at 8 Eastern Time. Two of the best players in the country, the headliners in that game, Tyler Hansbrough of North Carolina and Jared Dudley of Boston College. Duke did a great job shutting down Dudley in the Blue Devils' win at BC earlier this week. Life on the road has been rough for Washington. Only one win away from home this season. That was at Arizona State, a team that hasn't won a conference game in the Pac-10. A chance to get a huge road win here today at Pittsburgh.
Huskies' defense has been great. Pitt shooting 27% from the field so far.
Lindsey Pondexter miss and out of bounds. Last touch by John Brockman. Pittsburgh 4.5 minutes without a field goal for Jamie Dixon. Poor shooting the problem the other night. And it's carried over. And now you can sense uneasiness in the crowd, Bob. You made the point, you know, one night like the other night can be an aberration. But now we're almost halfway into the first half here today and still not the kind of Pitt team we're accustomed to seeing.
No. You mentioned the nine starters. Ramon is the guy who can heat it up from the outside, and Young, the best shooter and the best athlete, come off the bench. They have not gotten Gray involved at all.
Tyrell Big, strong baseline drive, and a blocking foul called against Justin Dentman.
And the reason that's a blocking foul is he was standing underneath the basket when Justin tried to take that charge. Cook is a very athletic player. He takes the ball strong here. Nice pump fake, drive to the basket. And you can see Dentman standing underneath. And they're happy about that one.
First foul on Dentman. Biggs converts the three-point play. First field goal in over 6 minutes for Pittsburgh. But down by only three. Pondexter, nice pass to Brockman. He missed the shorty, perhaps altered by the seven-footer Gray. And on the second chance opportunity, Brockman scores. He has four.
Brockman's one of those guys who's extremely physical. Knocks his own guys down, knocks the opponents down, knocks the fans down. Burly guy, 6'7", about 250.
Graves inside for Gray, defended tightly by Wallace, who chested him up away from the basket, out of bounds to the Huskies.
This is an un-Gray-like play right here. Normally very dependable, getting lots of attention. See Appleby bumps him, both seven-footers on him on the sideline, and he shoots an air ball. You don't see that very much from Aaron Gray.
And a whistle underneath. Mike Cook called for bodying up on Quincy Pondexter. Gray, the backup player behind Chris Taft for his first couple of years. As a junior, last year the most improved player in the Big East. And this year the Big East Conference preseason player of the year, and living up to it, averaging a double-double for the season.
A number of players like that in the league this year. Demetrius Nichols of Syracuse, Russell Carter. All guys who were bit players and now stars for their team.
Pondexter the bucket. The average is 11 points per game, but has not been in double figures in any of the last seven. He was their leading scorer before they went into the conference schedule. And Lorenzo Romar says the other teams have been doing a lot to take away Pondexter. He's been seeing much more attention from the defense. Nice pass underneath. Biggs couldn't finish off the Cook feed.
We mentioned Hawes' heritage with his dad and uncle being great players. Pondexter, the same thing. Dad Roscoe played. His uncle played for the Celtics. You should know about him.
With Pondexter, Quincy Pondexter's uncle, drafted by the Celtics, actually played for the Chicago Bulls for 3 years. And Roscoe Pondexter, Quincy's dad, played at Long Beach State for Lute Olson and then went overseas for about 10 years to play professionally. Quincy was recruited heavily by Arizona, nearly went to play for his dad and uncle's former college coach, Lute Olson, but elected to come to Seattle instead. Ramon fouled. And he'll go to the free throw line, one of the best free throw shooters in the Big East. At 86%, two fouls now on Quincy Pondexter.
Washington doing a very good job of clogging the lane, and therefore they've taken Gray away. Also trying to take a few charges, a little late on that one. So you can see Lorenzo Romar's strategy in this game is take away the inside, clog it as much as possible, try to force Pitt to make some shots from the perimeter.
Malone's been in a shooting slump lately from the floor, but it has not affected his free throw shooting. Third all-time in Pitt history from the line. Better than 83% career from the stripe. He makes both. A five-point game into which LaVance Fields returns, and Ramon heads out. He got a haircut during the week.
That That's right.
Jake I saw him bushy before the hairdo game, man. The other day when Coach Dixon said he's just trying to be taller.
I don't know. If you carry too much hair around, it affects your jump shot, I think. He could talk to Noah of Florida about the long hair.
I wouldn't know anything about carrying too much hair around, but I'll take your word for it. I'd like to have that problem.
At one time, you must have had
long,
hair.
Long time ago.
Pitch signature, half-court defense.
And Hawes turns to score over Kendall. 4 points for Spencer Hawes. The most highly touted recruit ever to come to the University of Washington. McDonald's and Parade All-American last year out of Seattle Prep, where he averaged 20 points and 11 rebounds per game. Graves, a deep three that spins out. Gray, the offensive rebound and score.
They need that badly, and the students know it. He is pivotal for this team.
It's his first bucket for Aaron Gray, averaging 14 a game. Hawes steps out and misses. And a foul on the rebounding action as Oliver crashed the boards, and the foul's against Pittsburgh. It's against Aaron Gray, his first.
Well, no one in the building likes that except the guys with the Husky uniforms on.
Gray's not arguing. Tallest player ever at Pittsburgh. At over 7 feet, Mark Bont in the NBA, now the only other seven-footer ever to play for the Panthers. Brockman to play it in. Oliver, freshman out of Modesto, California, Modesto Christian High School. Appleby trying to drive on Graves. And another whistle away from the ball, and it's a moving screen on John Brockman. His first foul in the Huskies' fourth. And a timeout. 7:52 remaining first half. Spencer Hawes and the Huskies leading by five.
There's a place where simple food like chicken is now simply extraordinary. Introducing Chicken Fresco, Portobello, and Oscar. Our freshest, tastiest chicken ever. Ruby Tuesday.
Big sports fans, but recently I had some trouble fitting in.
But Lance Armstrong probably wins 7 marathons too.
He was
talking sports
out of my lack of information.
Please, the Spurs have no chance this year.
But then I started watching ESPN News. It's constantly updated, 24-hour sports news. So now I know sports. Better yet, I sound like I know sports.
It's Millennium Hyundai's biggest President's Day sale ever. Save big on the best sign-and-drive lease deals. $199 on a brand-new Sonata. $229 on a sporty Santa Fe. There's never been a bigger sale. Get 0% financing on all 2007 Hyundais. Or double factory rebates up to $5,000. Get the best deal ever on the Hyundai of your choice. All backed by the Hyundai Advantage. America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. It's Millennium Hyundai's President's Day sale. Our biggest ever. Going on now.
Tune in to John Baisdell TV, television fit to watch.
I feel the love.
This is real reality.
Only on MySpace.
Dave Revson of the Sports Center in-game update. Get you the latest on UCLA and Arizona. Lorenzo Mata, the block on one end, and then good hustle. Follows it up, puts the Bruins up by six. They're up seven right now, and Vandy continues to lead Florida up by eight on number one. 12 minutes to go. Sean and Bob.
All right, Dave, that's obviously a huge game for the Bruins, as right behind them in the Pac-10 standings, a game behind Washington State, one of the biggest pleasant surprises in the country this year, picked to finish last in the Pac-10 preseason poll. They are second in the league, 11th in the country. Five teams this week out of the Pac-10 in the top 25. That's the most of any conference in the nation.
It's
and
been
Washington,
a good year, huh?
A little bit down from what was expected, but not what Lorenzo Romar expected.
Good year for the Pac-10. UCLA, of course, made it to the national championship game last year, and they're having a good year this year. They're expecting seven teams.
As Reese Davis told us on College Game Day this morning, the conference with the highest collective RPI right now is the SEC. A lot of people believe the Pac-10 is the strongest in the land this year.
The reason for the SEC in that situation is they are so good all the way through. Pac-10 has a few teams who are not that good, and that brings their total RPI down. But in terms of top teams, I'm very impressed. If this team is 6-8 in the league, I'll tell you what, it's a pretty strong league. They're playing with great poise right here on the road.
Denton, a tough pass. He got it into Brockman, who lowered his shoulder, and he got called for a charge over Mike Cook. College basketball continues later today on ABC. Regional coverage, either the UConn Huskies at Syracuse, sixth-ranked Texas A&M at Oklahoma, or Tennessee facing South Carolina. Coverage begins at 3:30 Eastern time, 12:30 Pacific on ABC. Check your local listings for the game in your area. Syracuse, a bubble team. Joe Lenardi, our bracketologist, has them one of his last four teams in the field right now. But certainly they are on the bubble either way and could use a big win at home against Connecticut. Mike Cook scores, and he'll go to the line, fouled by Oliver, his first.
You talk about an acrobatic move. Cook posting and Aaron Gray making the pass. An interesting contrast. Usually Gray is inside posting. Here he goes to the high post and becomes an assist man, and the smaller guy posting up. Nice, intricate move by Jamie Dixon. Role reversal.
Cook, a junior from Philadelphia, gets the bounce. His first year playing at Pittsburgh. Sat out last year as a transfer from East Carolina, where he led the Pirates in scoring 2 years ago at 15 a game. Appleby with Dentman, now Wallace, out there with Hawes and Oliver for the University of Washington.
Big guys kind of neutralizing themselves in this game so far. Gray and Hawes.
Wallace, crowd thought he walked. Hawes with bodies flying. Gray, the rebound, and the push ahead to LaVance Fields. Graves blocked by Appleby. And now he looks to run with Hawes and waits for more help.
A lot of action, no points.
Hawes one-on-one with the seven-footer Gray. Finds Oliver open for a line drive three. 6 points off the bench for Adrian Oliver on a couple of three balls. Had 11 three-pointers all year coming into today's game. And a timeout, Panthers.
Things that make modern life modern come from one place, chemistry. Learn more at AmericanChemistry.com.
Well, not only is this a tough place for any visiting team to play, but history is not on the Washington Huskies' side today. They have lost 31 in a row on the road against teams ranked in the top 10. You have to go back to 1974. When the Huskies won at Kansas for their last road win against the top 10 foe.
They are good at home, however.
Ramon A miss. The rebound by Wallace. Lorenzo Romar getting some good minutes off his bench. As Washington has built the lead and held it virtually throughout this first half. That was the case the other night against Louisville, when Louisville jumped out to a 13-2 lead in the first 5 minutes, and Pittsburgh never got back within single digits. Mike Cook, he has 8 for the Panthers. 5 minutes to go in the half. They're down by 3.
Getting out of here.
Wow. Appleby behind the head pass. Now he has it back from Wallace. Hawes at inside position on Gray. Couldn't get away from Gray, and it called for a 3-second violation.
Big men tend to negate one another, and in a big game like this, this is happening. The 2 7-footers going after one another. Solid defense by Gray. Hawes just steps out of bounds inadvertently. Oh no, 3-second count. No offensive explosion by either Gray or Hawes in this one. Earlier this year, Sean, the two big guys in the Big East, Hibbert and Gray, against one another, they had 11 each. And Hawes tonight so far getting the better of it. Has nice skills, doesn't he? A little turnaround right there, using the glass properly. Sees the floor nicely. You can see why he was thought of as one of the best incoming freshmen in the land.
Bothered by injuries and illness, you mentioned the virus that plagued him the entire month of January. Hawes lost about 15 pounds in January. Lorenzo Romar said he went a 2-week stretch where he never got through one practice. He didn't play well during that time, as you might expect. He was sick. The average fan, Lorenzo Romar said, was saying, well, if he's healthy enough to be out there, he should be able to play better. When Lorenzo said he deserved credit for just being out there, a lot of guys wouldn't even try to have played as sick as Hawes was. He's also come back from a knee injury, a minor scope, right before the season started, and a sprained ankle that kept them out of their loss at Washington State. Appleby called for the foul, his first.
And despite all of that you've just enumerated, he is really beginning to play well. Last two games, big numbers, 18 and 22 against Stanford and Washington State.
Because he's healthy, as yep. Coach Romar said. That's an example of what he can do when feeling well. His dad, Jeff, is here. As Bob mentioned earlier, he played at Washington, was a good player back in the early and mid-70s. His brother and Spencer's uncle, Steve, was a better player. He's a Husky Hall of Famer, played 10 years in the NBA. That Steve Hawes averaged over 8 points per game for his NBA career. The lead down to 1 now for Washington, and a 5-second call as Denman spent too much time dribbling.
Pittsburgh is one of those teams that you don't see a lot of highlights with them, but they are fundamentally sound, and their defense is outstanding. Stay within 3 feet of your man. You stay between him and the basket for 5 seconds, and that becomes a violation. Excellent by Fields.
4 minutes to go, a chance for the lead, a rarity in the first half for Pittsburgh. Levon Kendall, a miss. Good rebound in traffic underneath by Sam Young. And a new shot clock. Fields brings it out with Ramon, Young, Kendall, and Cook. Aaron Gray getting a breather.
Good judgment by Fields, huh? Didn't over-penetrate.
Very good point guard, Vance Fields. Young rattles it home, and Pittsburgh on an 11-3 run has taken the lead. Their first lead since it was 7-5. Fields thought he had a steal. Instead, there's a foul.
We talked about how good Fields is. 120 assists, only 45 turnovers. That's what you want out of a point guard.
Foul on Fields, his first, and a timeout.
Winter, a time to raise the heat. But as anticipation builds, the question remains, how to exceed expectations. Patience, because a game breaks down in time. Be wary of the minutes, but it's the seconds that change everything. For the moment will fall, so take the risk and play like there's no tomorrow. The NCAA Winter Championships on ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPNU.
Chalo to Gudong. Red carpets, stunning vistas, and hairpin turns. In no particular order. Range Rover Sport, designed for the extraordinary.
Having a bad day?
You have to honor the correct price. You got that?
I can't do this many leaves for $10.
Or a bad year?
Error. I have to research alternative specs.
Searching alternative specs.
What? Shut down.
On March 2nd, they were four friends stuck in a rut.
We need to get away.
Until they hit the road.
What do we have here?
Not quite what it looks like.
Are you wearing pants?
No.
Wild Hogs. Rated PG-13.
I'm okay. I just hurt my face.
Starts March 2nd.
Innovations from Siemens can be found everywhere. By integrating communications, building technologies, and advanced medical systems, we're creating digital hospitals that can provide higher quality patient care. Siemens, we're turning dreams into reality.
Dave Revson in the studio, UPS Halftime Report just moments away. Tom Brennan, Doug Gottlieb will join me. Number one, Florida is in a load of trouble right now against Vanderbilt. We will have the highlights of that game. Also show you the thrilling finish between Georgetown and Villanova. Let you know how that one went down. And UCLA trying to win on the road at Arizona. Looks like that one will go down to the wire. We'll have the highlights coming up in mere moments, Sean.
All right, Dave, we'll look forward to it. A lot of very important games throughout college basketball today. Particularly important here for Washington in need of a signature win. Their most impressive win at home against Oregon. Now trying to win on the road at Pittsburgh, where only one non-conference team has ever won. Bucknell, in the five-year history of this building, 78-8 are the Panthers at home at the Pete. Losses here this year to Marquette and most recently Monday night to Louisville.
Watch the hands of the defensive players on Pitt. Hands out wide, take away passing lanes. Hard to get the ball inside.
Hans Gasser in for the first time now for Washington, one of two seniors on this Husky team. One of them plays very much. Haw's shot deflected by Gray and a shot clock violation as the ball goes out of bounds.
That was excellent defense. Long time staying on defense. Only one interior pass. Jamie Dixon has to be happy about that one.
Washington had a 7-point lead at 20-13. Since then, Pittsburgh on an 11-3 run. Gray back in, guarded by Haw's.
Trying to post Cook on the smaller Oliver.
Young into a three, foul on the rebounding action. Whistled by Mike Kitts. He has one of the Huskies on a hold. They're over the limit in team fouls. And some tempers flaring.
Cook is stronger than Oliver. As a result, Jamie Dixon trying to post his guard rather than his big people. And of course, right here, he's in good position. Oliver obviously grabs his shirt. That's allowed on the playground, but not here.
Second foul on Oliver, so Cook returns to the free throw line. Two out of three today. He has 8 points. He still has eight as he missed the first of a 1-1. And Haw's rebounded the miss to Dentman. He's from Carbondale, Illinois. Played prep basketball at the Winchendon School in Massachusetts. Haw's traveled and got away with it. No, he didn't. Mike Kitts the call. The whistle a little slower than Jamie Dixon and the crowd would have liked, but he got it in the final analysis.
Watch his feet when he catches the ball. Moves both of them at the same time. Not allowed to do that. One must stay on the ground as the pivot foot. Youthful mistake. Or on the other end, if you're playing in the NBA, sometimes that sort of thing is allowed.
Yeah, that's only halfway toward a travel in the NBA. Haw's will be able to do that in a few years. And he is in the NBA. LaVance Fields for three.
Great competitiveness.
Out of Zavarian High School, Brooklyn, New York. Same school that sent Chris Taft to Pittsburgh and Chris Mullen onto what might be a Hall of Fame career. He's one of the finalists just announced for the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame. Appleby, tough runner. Gray rips it down with one hand. Momentum on the side of the running Panthers. Fields and a blocking foul called. Fields will go to the line.
This has been very, very aggressive at both ends of the floor. And LaVance Fields is stepping up big time for Pittsburgh, as he usually does. Wide open jumper because Washington concerned about the interior and guarding the paint. And as a result, a good rhythm shot with great rotation. Fields had 24 at Syracuse when they were in trouble up there.
Makes the first free throw. Lorenzo Romar starting to get a little agitated with these officials. Foul on his team, the Huskies' ninth. First on Gasser. Fields gets both. And with a minute and a half to go, Romar and the Huskies down by six as Biggs comes in for Gray. Four turnovers, only one field goal the last seven possessions. For Washington, they averaged 79 points per game. Fields called for what our pal Bill Raftery would call a nickel dimer. So they gave it to Ramon away from the ball. His first, team sixth. Only Arizona is a higher scoring team in the Pac-10 than those Huskies at 79 a game. Gasser for three. Just his sixth three-point field goal of the year for Hans Gasser, the senior from Issaquah, Washington.
How about that? Gasser and Oliver, not known for their three-point shooting, keeping Washington in it. Pick and roll is what they need.
And a hand check on Appleby. That'll put it into the double bonus. 10-team fouls on Washington.
Pittsburgh has not allowed Washington to get to the free throw line in this game. And at the other end, Pittsburgh going frequently. A testament to the Panthers' D.
Three fouls on Appleby. Fields makes the free throw. Coming out of Zavarian, he was the most valuable player in the Michael Jordan High School All-Star Classic after his senior year. Had 18 points. A lot of friends and family in attendance at Madison Square Garden. John Brockman, now with Washington, was in that game playing with a mask on. He had broken his nose.
Fields following in the footsteps of Krauser and Knight. They've had great point guards here over the last 6 years.
One of the reasons why they've been so successful, six straight years for Pittsburgh with at least 20 overall wins and at least 10 in the Big East.
They have clamped down. Look at this position.
It's helped them that Brockman's been out of the game with two fouls for Washington. And Gasser fouled with 4 seconds on the shot clock. The first whistled against Levon Kendall. I mentioned Lorenzo Romar agitated with the officials. This is the first free throw Washington has shot in the game upcoming from Gasser, while Pittsburgh is 11 out of 13 from the line. Gasser 76% from the line. Gray will come back in for what the Panthers hope will be the last shot of the half. Hawes goes out. Wallace back in for the Huskies.
After a bad start, Pitt has really come on strongly. And they've done it with their defense and runouts.
5 points off the bench for Hans Gasser. He averages three per game. He and Brandon Burmeister, who's not played yet today, are the only seniors on this team. They have a chance to be the only players in the history of the Washington basketball program to go to four NCAA tournaments.
Thanks in part to Brandon Roy, huh, and Nate Robinson.
Fields, a contested three, the rebound Wallace, and it's halftime. Washington had a 7-point lead. Pittsburgh has come back to take a 3-point advantage into the locker room. Not much from either 7-footer in front of the 20 NBA scouts and the sellout crowd at the peak. Now let's send you back to the studio, the UPS halftime report. Here's Dave Revson.
Thanks, Sean. Non-conference opponents 1-46 all time at the Peterson Event Center, but Washington certainly hanging around. UPS halftime report coming up. Is there a flaw in the Gators? Doug Gottlieb will tell us that as we check in on an upset alert against Vandy and Tom Brennan on Villanova's finish against Georgetown.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Liberty Mutual. Responsibility. What's your policy? And the 2007 Range Rover Sport, designed for the extraordinary.
An insurance company, they call it Liberty Mutual. Responsibility. What's your policy? Liberty Mutual.
Monte Carlo to Godon. Red carpets, stunning vistas, and hairpin turns. In no particular order, Range Rover Sport, designed for the extraordinary.
I've always considered myself a pretty knowledgeable sports fan. That was until recently.
They finally got those college football rankings down to a science.
He was talking sports out of his...
ignorance, really.
Boy, that Vince Young turned out to be a bust, huh?
I didn't know that by watching ESPN News, I could get up-to-the-minute sports news 24 hours a day. So now when I talk sports, I do it right.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
Washington, 31 straight losses against top 10 opponents on the road, a streak that dates back to 1974. They've got a shot, though, against number 5 Pitt. It's a 3-point game at the half. Welcome in. It is the UPS Halftime Report. Great to have you with us. Dave Revson alongside Tom Brennan and Doug Gottlieb. Going to start you off with number 1 on the ropes. Vanderbilt's beaten 5 number 1 teams all time. That's the second most in the SEC, behind only Kentucky. Kevin Stallings' team giving Florida all it can handle. Alex Gordon out of the corny. Vandy up by 10. And then check this out, guys. A little controversy.
Well, Kevin Stallings gets the ball. All Joe Kim Noah does want the basketball. Kevin Stallings kind of a fiery competitor, but I actually think he was completely out of line with his behavior there.
Never talk to another player under any circumstances.
Still a 10-point Vandy lead. Ross Neltner for 3, so they're up by 13. That's when Florida makes a bit of a run. 11-point game. Lee Humphrey can shoot it.
You know what's interesting about this place, Dave, is it's a really interesting place to play in terms of it's not like any other gym in the country. And so shooting there for an opponent is sometimes a problem.
Well, it wasn't a problem for Vanderbilt. Derek Byers with a nice feed there. Free throw would give Vandy a 9-point lead, and then it's Byers doing it himself just beyond the free throw line. Vanderbilt, guys, up by 15. Looks like number 1 is going to go down. Let's check in on UCLA and Arizona. Bruins have won 4 straight against the Wildcats. Darren Collison back in the lineup and making his impact felt.
Guess he wasn't important against West Virginia last Saturday, defense. Huh?
Come on, man. Nobody was even near him. You got to guard him a little bit.
Later in the first, Jordan Hill.
But actually, that was irrelevant. West Virginia wins that game anyway.
Oh, okay.
12-0 run there by Arizona.
This
and then a flallow for 3.
Oh, he is so good. By the way, how soft is Arizona? Seriously.
I'm telling you.
You want to talk about the all-time disappointing teams. Arizona right there up on the list this year.
They are down by 13 right now to UCLA. At home, Arizona is final 2 minutes. In Wisconsin, no problem with Penn State. Orlando Tucker at 22. Badgers 21st straight home win. Georgetown Villanova. Nova trying to complete the season sweep of the Hoyas. Jesse Sapp. Check this out. Right before halftime, beyond half court,
Nova had an 11-point lead, and this ended up making the halftime lead only 2. That was vital, vital. Georgetown believed they were still in the game at the half.
It really took some momentum into the locker room. Scotty Reynolds, obviously an NBA 3. Cat shot just 35%, though. And it's Roy Hibbert.
The big problem was, I think, Dave, was the fact that Villanova tried to trap him and pressure him, and Georgetown kept getting over the top for dunks, and that was one thing that Villanova thought they could do, but were not able to.
Jeff Green at 19 in the game, career-high 8 blocks. Final 10 seconds, Shane Clark misses. Georgetown gets the rebound. They're fouled. Then one last chance for Villanova. Reynolds can't get it to go. And Georgetown wins its ninth straight, 58-55. Oh, we've seen some interesting games so far to this point in the day. What jumps out at you, Coach?
Well, the one thing that was that interested me greatly in the Villanova game was the fact that I was down there Tuesday when they played St. Joe, and Jay was saying to me that we have to give the ball to Scotty Reynolds, and the seniors have to understand that. I brought him in. We talked about it. He's the best player. He's got to be our guy, and he said everyone has bought into that. Now, tonight it just wasn't enough. They may be 1 year away, but Villanova's going to be a good program, and Reynolds is going to be a heck of a player.
You know, guys, what jumps out at me is I'm starting to call them Team Clapper. I mean, you know, remember the clap on, clap off? That's right. Sure. That's the one. The Clapper.
Great product.
That's has anybody actually buy that product?
I've never.
I'm not really sure. Maybe Florida thinks they should buy that product because Florida's had this Team Clapper type image where they just think they can clap on and start to play defensively, specifically in the second half. We saw it against Alabama. They got down really big early on, playing at home at the O Dome. Now they take on a Vanderbilt team who's stomping on them. And the one thing Florida has to battle, they won the national championship last year, they've still shown the ability to win big games this year, is complacency. And so far today, and you go back to their last several games, they've been complacent. Even against a Kentucky team, Saturday night, primetime, Dick Vitale and the boys there, that was a couple. How good did they look? I mean, they kept them at arm's distance, but Kentucky still had a chance at the end.
Part of their problem is midnight madness. I mean, you know, we keep telling these teams how good they are all the time. These kids are sitting there watching all this stuff, and then every night they don't play. They just kind of think they can show up and win, and it's not the way.
How many times have we said it, guys? You rely too much on being Team Clapper. After a while, someone's going to take out the Ginsu Knives and get you. They're going to get you. All right, coming up later on ABC.
That's what I love about you. You got to pay attention. Time,
UConn and Syracuse, Texas A&M, Oklahoma.
Stinka! Who would have thought? UConn and Syracuse, a stinka.
Regional action. Please do not downplay what we have.
Stinka!
On the network. There are some people who are very interested. Syracuse is on the bubble, Doug. Don't you know?
We're going to give you.
Spencer Hawes, 4 points so far in the first half. Washington giving Pitt all it can handle. A tight game, 3-point game at the break.
Right, reliability. Well, looks like a package is heading south on 995. It was shipped yesterday, it weighs 11 pounds, and it should arrive by 8:30 a.m.
It's early.
So how'd I know all that? Well, this is a smart label, and it knows everything about your package. And it's only
from UPS.
It's not reliability. It's UPS reliability.
Oh, sorted in Philly.
They're called tiendas, thousands of tiny storefronts across Central America that sell food and goods to millions. But delivering refrigerated food to them takes a different approach than for big stores. So Cargill built a creative distribution system, equipping salespeople with icebox scooters and handheld computers to call on the tiendas and deliver the small but essential inventory they need when they need it. This is how Cargill works with customers.
Carlo to Godon. Red carpets, stunning vistas, and hairpin turns. In no particular order, Range Rover Sport, designed for the extraordinary.
It is rude and insincere to tell a man he just dunked it. What kind of dunk was it? You got the windmill, the waffle cone, the Moroccan princess, the cranky valet, and oh! Now right there. That's the two-fisted, triple-pumping, intercontinental rim-wrecking double dunk. Call it what it is, and give that man some respect.
NBA Street, home court, ready to eat for everyone.
We're all over it, not to worry. Yes, the team is with me, we got it covered.
Who's he talking to?
The boss.
I thought the boss was at a board meeting.
He is at a board meeting.
Uh-oh.
They're asking about our global integration plan.
Do not worry.
Do we have a global integration plan?
It's more like a deck.
A deck?
A draft, really.
A deck is only a draft?
Afraid so.
It's not only doable, it's practically done. We better get started.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
Cinderella's slipper fit for an 11-18 Oakland team when it faced Oral Roberts.
No number seven seed has ever won the Mid-Continent Championship. Two-point game. Marshall runs into a teammate. Three from the corner. Yes! And Oakland is going to the NCAA.
Couple teams that will need a great run during championship week, St. John's and Providence. First half, Anthony Mason Jr. for the Red Storm. Up 16-11. Now Providence. Herbert Hill's been a force for them inside.
No, he's really good. I mean, Providence does have bits and pieces of a talented team. They just lose their way at times against the bigger name teams in the Big East.
Did not lose their way in this one. Hill. No one's covering him. Throws it down. 5-point win for Providence over St. John's. A couple other scores to pass along from the ACC. Virginia continues to solidify its case. 73-70 over Florida State.
Florida State dead. We all agree?
Yeah, I think yes, they are. They're dead. Certainly headed in the wrong direction.
Lost at home this week and on the road. Yeah, they're dead.
And Wake, a winner, 74-69 over Miami. Levance Fields with 9 points in the first half.
How about how much better that kid's gotten all during his career? He's really getting better and better all the time.
Pittsburgh on top of Washington by 3, second half next.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Nissan, who invites you to shift the way you move through the world, and Olivia, redefining high def.
Does it have 270 horsepower? Fuel-efficient CVT technology. And faster 0 to 60 than Accord, Camry, and Acura TL. Performance once reserved for the few is now available to everyone. Yep, it's that good. The next generation Nissan Altima is here.
Ready, honey?
Ready.
You looking?
Not looking, are you looking?
You're looking.
Can I help you? We just need to walk through the bath department. We can't look.
Because can't afford a remodel right now.
Well, actually, you don't have to spend a lot to make a big difference.
Really?
Let Lowe's show you how to give your kitchen or bath a makeover without giving your budget a workover.
Honey?
Yeah. You don't have to spend a lot to fix up your kitchen either.
Lowe's.
Oh, good.
Good.
Let's build something together.
Use your Lowe's consumer card and pay nothing for 12 months on any purchase of $299 or more.
At T. Rowe Price, successful investing is about balancing risk and reward intelligently. For each 1, 5, and 10-year period, 70% of our mutual funds beat their Lipper average, finding the right opportunity. Low-cost mutual funds from T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence. Request a complete prospectus or profile with investment objectives, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
Most trusted SUV 13 years running. Over 3 times more towing capacity than a Honda Pilot. First in class available power fold third row seat. Surprised? You shouldn't be. Not when Explorer has been America's best selling SUV for 14 straight years. And now this well equipped Ford Explorer Eddie Bauer Edition can be yours for a surprisingly low $279 a month during our special President's Day event. Come on, baby,
let's go. Sunday. The rules will be broken. Iconic predators will fight for their lives. Threatened by outsiders, their environment, and archenemies. Because even the invincible are vulnerable. On Planet Carnivore, Sunday starting at 8 on Channel 162, the National Geographic Channel. Dare to explore.
And welcome back to our presentation of college basketball brought to you by Cars.com, the sold-out Peterson Event Center on the campus of the University of Pittsburgh, where the Panthers lead Washington 31-28. At halftime, Sean McDonough and Bob Wenzel, welcome back. Washington had it going its way, Bob, for much of that half. They led 20-15 with about 7 minutes to go in the half. Then Jaden Brockman got a second foul. Pittsburgh on a 16-8 run thereafter.
Yeah, and they did it with defense. And after they did it with defense, they got those runouts. They had 15 points on runout plays, and that really got them the lead in the second half. The big guys, Sean, were very interesting. You know, we talked about how great they were. They've negated themselves. Both coaches came into this game tactically saying, we're going to take away Hawes and Gray. And they did it with double teaming. Big guys on big guys. The small players would come in and help out. We've seen two air balls by each of these outstanding guys. They're the leading scorers on their teams, and they've been virtually invisible in the first half in the scoring area.
Turnovers, as Bob said, hurt Washington. Hit the decided edge at the free throw line as well. LaVance Fields leads all scorers with 9 points. He was 6 out of 6 from the line for Pittsburgh. Two of them combined to average 30 points per game. They combined for 6 in the first half. Did Hawes and Gray. Collectively, they were 3 out of 13 from the floor. Hawes, 2 for 8.
Pittsburgh plays a lot of games in the 60s. Unfamiliar for Washington. They like the high-scoring games.
Well, Hawes trying to make it a different second half. It's a deep two. He has 6. The Huskies within 1. LaVance Fields with the ball for Pitt to Mike Cook. With Aaron Gray, Levon Kendall, Antonio Graves. Cook gets the bounce, and now he leads all scorers with 10.
Interestingly enough, how they put Hawes on the high post for the first play. You know, he's a capable outside shooter. Maybe the strategy will be for Lorenzo Romar to pull him away from the basket and force Gray to guard him out at 17 feet.
Graves in the Gray. He gets doubled, and Kendall is wide open and missed it. Cook in the right spot. Mike Cook has been struggling lately with his offense, but he's leading the way with 12 tonight for Pittsburgh, or this afternoon, we should say. Strong drive by Brockman. Sophomore from Snohomish, Washington, in the Seattle area. And what a nice compliment Lorenzo Romar paid him when we visited with the coach last night. He said every team wants a guy like him, a bruising, relentless banger who makes plays. It's not all about him. He's a great team leader.
Amen. And it's nice to have a guy who can block shots alongside of him. These two inside, very, very, very good. And this drive, you know, he's a 255-pound guy going past Kendall.
Graves a quick three attempt, and Gray missed a short putback. Cook rescued it to Kendall. Fields underneath for Cook.
He's everywhere.
For Mike Cook, his season high is 18 against Georgetown. Levon Kendall called for a block. 2 fouls on the fifth-year senior.
This is a beautiful assist, and Cook in the right place at the right time. He hustled to get the ball in bounds and then got right back in. He's got a nose for scoring.
Demon to Pondexter, and Cook gets called for bodying up on Pondexter.
Well, you talked about Brockman only playing 11 minutes in the first half. Pondexter, the starting three man, only 9 minutes because of 2 fouls on him as well. So two starters didn't play a lot in the first half for Washington.
Ooh, dangerous inbounding pass. Hawes came to it to help rescue it, and he found Detman in the corner for a 3. Justin Detman, oldest of 6 children, being raised by a single mom. He says perhaps he spent too much time thinking about an NBA future to help his family. Realizes he needs to improve his game at the college level if the NBA is going to be a reality. The rebound by Hawes. Here come the Huskies now, 2 to tie and 3 to reclaim the lead. Brockman got shut off by Gray and turned it over. 4-on-1 pick. Graves missed it. Kendall attempt. Brockman crashes. Kendall rescues it out to Graves.
Wow. That was awful. How can a guy miss that shot? Especially the tense of the situation, huh?
Kendall fouled. By Hawes, his first.
That is a 9 on the difficulty scale. Switched it to his left hand. Very, very nice play by Kendall, who's not a great scorer. Right here, notice how he uses his left hand. Shields off the defender. Concerned about the shot block. Very nice play. You know, he plays so much for that Canadian national team. He's got lots and lots of experience. Even though not a big scorer, really knows how to play.
He's just about everything else. 74% from the line, missed the free throw. Kendall has 4. Pittsburgh's lead is 4. Nearly 3 minutes played, second half. Adrian Oliver in off the bench. He gave him nice minutes in the first half. And that continues right on cue. He had 6 points in the first half, played 15 minutes, had 3 rebounds for Washington, now has 8.
And he averages 5 per game on the year, so outstanding play by Oliver in a tough venue for a freshman.
His career high is 14 points way back in November against Eastern Washington. Kendall from the elbow, long rebound, great, tipped it, got tangled up with his own man Fields, and now Ryan Appleby. First team All-State in high school in Washington. Aaron Brooks, the great star at Oregon, was also a first team All-Stater on that same squad in Washington that year. You mentioned the impressive win, the most impressive win, Bob, for Washington against Oregon, but Aaron Brooks didn't play in that game. He was suspended, so that diminishes the win just a bit.
Indeed it does.
Kendall, the running left, would not go. Appleby snares it.
And, you know, the Pac-10 suspended him, Sean, and it was for something he did last year in the Pac-10 tournament. Very good justice. Interesting. They don't suspend him for the next game. They suspend him for a game against the team where he made the play.
Oz from just underneath the free throw line. The miss. Gray got hit in the mouth. Maybe even in the nose. And a timeout with the Panthers up by 2.
ESPN College Game Day is on campus, Saturdays at 11 a.m. and 8 p.m.
The only car in his class was standard push-button ignition, intelligent key, and available real-time traffic updates. Luxuries once reserved for the few are now available to everyone. Yep, it's that good. The next generation Nissan Altima is here.
Yeah, Bob, we're going to need some stuff, lots of stuff, actually. I'm going to need 6 notebooks, 3 printers,
an office phone system, a wireless network.
We need blade servers,
data storage.
Oh, good idea. Excellent. I like where your head's at.
And we're going to need security, of course, and then all the stuff that goes with the stuff.
With a complete range of technology products that meet all of your IT needs, we're there. CDW.
Now we're in business.
You blink, and they're in grade school. Blink again, high school. And again, college. Which we still haven't figured out how to pay for. Either I've got to save more, or blink less.
Putting minds at ease for 150 years. Northwestern Mutual. Insurance. Investments. Ideas.
I've been to Newark, Hackensack, 3 meetings back-to-back.
Conference in Maine, put faces to names.
Seminar, Lombard, big stack of business cards.
Stayed at Comfort Suites, got a hot breakfast free.
Warehouse inventory, foreman had a funny story.
Big meeting, New Rochelle, told my boss all went well.
This spring, stay at any Comfort Inn, Comfort Suites, Quality Inn, Sleep Inn, or Clarion Hotel. You'll earn triple choice privileges points or triple airline rewards with your second stay. For reservations, visit choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels, we'll see you there.
Yeah. It's Code Red in the house with our good friends from ESPN. Woo! Letting you know, it's game time.
Ain't nobody had his ass up in your spot. Give it to you, play by play, it's shot for shot. ESPN is in the house, it's back to pop. They can see the one that's got the game on lock. And we can't, let's go.
And welcome back to the Peterson Events Center. Sean McDonough with Bob Wenzel. Aaron Gray and the Pitt Panthers with a 2-point lead. Just before the media timeout, Gray inadvertently hit in the face by Adrian Oliver.
It has been physical. Both ends of the floor. When the ball is in the air on the way to the basket, guys are knocking each other around.
Michael and Sandy Gray, Aaron's parents, made the trip from Emmaus, Pennsylvania. About an hour outside of Philadelphia.
Aaron's uncle Steve played for Duke when I was coaching there. He was on our team that went to the championship game.
Mansfield's a three-point try that popped out. So now again, two to tie and 3-4 to lead for Washington.
Look how long Fields becomes when he puts his hands out on the side. All the Pitt players sound fundamentally defensively. That's why Washington's having trouble. Look how far out Hawes catches the basketball.
Oliver kept it alive off the Hawes miss. And a new shot clock for the Huskies. Under 15 minutes to go now. Oliver a little floater. Rockman the offensive rebound to tie the game.
Well, there's the bruiser you talked about. 6'7", about 250. Understands the geography of the paint, where to position himself when shots go up.
Here's the Pac-10 player of the week last week. Double doubles in their wins over Cal and Stanford. We found out about the big honor. And he got a text message while in class from his brother Adam. What did we do before text messaging?
I don't know. But guys know how to position themselves on the weak side. I know about that part.
Big
numbers the last couple of games, huh?
Yeah, 22-14. Against Cal, 14-10 in the win over Stanford. That was a big win against a highly regarded Cardinal team. Brockman did just pick up his third foul at the defensive end to send Sam Young to the line.
They lost to the Northern California schools away and beat them at home. I like the way the Pac-10 does their scheduling. You know, they travel in pairs, the Oregon schools, the Washington schools, the North and South California schools and the Arizona schools, and it makes for a very nice 18-game schedule.
Well, a workable number with only the 10 teams. Hard to do something like that, obviously, in the Big East. It's impossible to do it with 16 teams. The Young free throws give Pittsburgh a two-point lead. Brockman missed the shorty. Oliver went over the back of Gray and got away with it.
Watch when a shot goes up, how many players are in the paint.
Detman bumped by Ramon. Crowd booing. They saw Oliver go over Gray's back without the whistle. Regional coverage on ABC later today starts at 3:30 Eastern. We'll see either Connecticut at Syracuse, Texas A&M at Oklahoma, or Tennessee and South Carolina. Check your local listings for the game in your area. Dentman gets the first. He's 82% from the line, fifth in the Pac-10. Brockman to the bench with three fouls. Gasser, who gave them good minutes as well in the first half, returns. Gasser played 5 minutes in the first half and had 5 points.
Unusual for him. Denton was all Pac-10 frosh last year, along with Brockman, two of the five guys from this team.
Young, short with a three, and the rebound to Quincy Pondexter. Having another quiet game. We mentioned averages 11, but a lot of that was in the pre-conference schedule. No double-figure games in the last seven for Pondexter, and only 2 points today. Trying to add to that total. Had a chance at the line as he was fouled by Keith Benjamin.
He's really their best one-on-one guy in terms of putting the ball on the floor. They clear a side for him, try to get him some space to operate at 6'6".
Coach Wilmer says he has all the tools to be a terrific player at this level. Just still learning how to play and score in bunches at 21 points and a half against Arizona. Finished with 25 in that game. He also put 25 on Idaho. 21 in his first career game against Pepperdine. In the conference, as he's seen more attention from the Pac-10 defense as the scoring has dropped off. His free throws put Washington back up.
Well, he's got to replace a guy like Bobby Jones and Jamal Williams, who were outstanding players last year at his spot for Washington.
Rodney Jones drafted in the NBA in the second round. Jamal Williams, an outstanding sixth man last year in the 26-win Husky squad. Sam Young bangs one in. He has six to put Pitt back on top.
The Pitt fans love Sam Young. They want him to get more minutes. Very, very athletic.
Oliver, the miss, and he fell down while shooting. Young had a chance ahead of the pack, but Gray didn't see him after the rebound. Cook, a quick miss in transition, and Vinton took down the board. And he was tripped by Young. Kind of indicative of the way the year's gone for Dentman. Young scores. Dentman adjusting to being a point guard. He said, I was a scorer in high school, came here trying to change my role, and he's still learning in year two.
He has had some very, very good games, as you've described, but also has been in a slump a part of this season.
Young has the last 6 points for Pittsburgh. Their lead is three. And another turnover. Gray saved it in the corner to Fields.
If you appreciate defense, you appreciate this game.
Fields is wide open in part because there was an illegal screen, says Bob Donato, on Aaron Gray.
Gray cleared a hole like it was the left side of the line in a football game. If this was allowed, guys would be open all the time. He blocked out two guys.
I don't think that would qualify as a moving screen. First Pitt turnover in 21 minutes. Just their fifth of the game after they had a season high against Louisville the other night, 19.
They normally take care of the ball very well. Look at the hands on D. Look at the physical play inside. Kendall and Hawes knocking each other around.
And Kendall needs to be careful. Very physical on Hawes. 10 seconds to shoot. Appleby finds room and scores to tie the game at 45. 8 points for Ryan Appleby.
His idol is Pete Maravich, and on that play you could see why. He's just missing the floppy socks. Remember, Maravich averaged 44 points a game for his college career.
Say Appleby has every video ever about Pete Maravich. A lot of the literature that's been written about him. There are a couple of new books out on the life of Pistol Pete. Omar says Appleby's one of the best shooters he's ever been around at any level. Of course, Lorenzo played 5 years in the NBA.
The defense evident. And Sam Young finishes.
And Appleby tying the game for Washington. The foul just now on Pondexter, his third.
We're all big sports fans, but recently I had some trouble fitting in.
But Lance Armstrong probably wins 7 marathons, too.
He
was talking sports
out of my lack of information.
Please, the Spurs have no chance this year.
But then I started watching ESPN News. It's constantly updated, 24-hour sports news. So now I know sports. Better yet, I sound like I know sports.
Does it have 270 horsepower? Fuel-efficient CVT technology? And faster 0 to 60 than Accord, Camry, and Acura TL? Performance once reserved for the few is now available to everyone. Yep, it's that good. The next generation Nissan Altima is here.
Is it for all of us?
Yeah. $1,600 for a week? We can do that.
Oh, yeah.
The magic begins when you realize you can afford a Disney vacation. Other affordable packages all year long. Visit DisneyWorld.com/affordable.
There's a place where simple food like chicken is now simply extraordinary. Introducing Chicken Fresco, Portobello, and Oscar. Our freshest, tastiest chicken ever. Ruby Tuesday.
When you've got a burning, scratchy sore throat, there's a whole new way to treat it. New Vicks 44 Sore Throat. with cooling Vicks Vapors goes to work fast. New Vicks 44 sore throat. Tell your sore throat to just chill.
The nation's longest winning streak is over at 17. Number one, Florida falls at Vanderbilt. Derek Byers, 24 to lead the way for the Doors. Their sixth win all time against number one. And those who are not in the library storm the court to celebrate. Big win for Vanderbilt. Meanwhile, Alabama, big over Kentucky early. We've seen this one before from the Crimson Tide, up by 12, guys.
Another terrific win for Vanderbilt. Didn't look like many students at the library there today. Alabama certainly needs that win. Pittsburgh fifth in the coaches' poll. Of course, that was before their loss to Louisville, so they could drop. And Jamie Dixon all week preaching to his team. They're playing for first place in the Big East when we get back in the conference, and they're playing for seeding in the NCAA tournament.
The seed is the most important thing, of course. They're clearly in. Right now, they would be a two. The thing is, you know, somebody loses like they lose, and everybody complains and worries about it, but everybody's losing. You know, North Carolina lost, now Florida loses. When that happens, no one changes their position.
Sam Young carrying the load of late for Pittsburgh. Mike Cook, the offensive rebound, and Hawes had it poked out of bounds by Young. So the ball back to Washington with a chance for the lead. 45 all, nearly midway through the second half.
Neither one of these teams has showed the ability to spurt on each other in this game at all. It's going to be a grind out.
Hawes forced far away from the basket by Gray. And it's tough when you're going against a seven-footer, even as a seven-footer, but neither one of these two certainly have helped themselves in front of these NBA scouts here today. Hawes showing his ability, blocks the shot by Young.
They're guarding the paint, the perimeter is open, but neither team accurate from there.
Adrian Oliver, Appleby, and now Pondexter. Trying to drive on Cook. Very tough shot. It rattles out to Ramon.
There's a difference in high school and college. In high school, you get that. You get it all the way to the basket. You get bumped here.
Young got it inside to Gray. Knocked out by Pondexter. 24 to shoot for Pittsburgh. Brockman back in. Gasser hustles out. Now Romar says, no, you stay in. Well, he hustles back in, and Hawes will come out of the ballgame.
They can't play with six.
You gotta like Gasser, whether he's going in the game, out of the game, he's going full speed. Ramon, native Dominican, moved to New York City at age 9. He has 4, the lead 2 for Pittsburgh. Under 10 minutes to go now. Good ball movement by Brockman. He found Gasser. Oliver crashes the boards, get tangled up with Fields. They hold it, and the ball will go to the Panthers. I hope you're enjoying our coverage of college basketball presented by Cars.com. Washington and Pittsburgh for the first time since 1950. And the first time ever in Pittsburgh at the event center. Sean McDonough with Bob Wenzel. Our producer Jonathan Lobovich, our director Bruce Watson, our ESPN crew, delighted to have you with us. Well, they were the stars coming in, leading scorer for each team, but really doing a lot to hold each other scoring down.
Amen. They've negated one another. Both coaches used the clogging of the lane technique with all of their players to take away the big men. Other players are going to have to win the game.
And the first player in the game now with 4 fouls is Quincy Pondexter. He couldn't stop Cook on the drive without fouling him. So he'll come out. Dentman comes back in. The team foul on University of Washington, the Huskies 4. Hawes returns and Gasser sprints to the bench.
Well, right now, Washington has 3 guards in the lineup. Pittsburgh has an opportunity to crash the boards with Oliver, Dentman, and Appleby all in the game at the same time.
Those 2 big men they have in. One of the best tandems in the country. Pittsburgh talking about playing against Hibbert and Green for Georgetown. And Hawes and Brockman are every bit as formidable. Crowd thought Brockman goaltended as he swatted that rebound away. Now out of bounds to Washington.
Well, Hall's got a great block shot on that one. When you're 7 feet tall and the game goes on, you might get tired, but you don't get shorter. And that looked like you're right. The ball was on the rim. They missed the basket interference. Nice to see guys playing above the rim, though.
Brockman, good position on Young.
Height advantage.
6'7", 260 is Brockman. He powered his way to the bucket. Over the 6'6", 215, Young. Out of bounds, last touch by Dentman.
Dentman's value in his aggressiveness. He's trying to get after Fields, and Fields needs a blow.
Tonight, Tyler Hansbrough in fourth-ranked North Carolina visit 21st-ranked Boston College, first place in the ACC on the line. It starts with College Game Day driven by State Farm at 8 Eastern. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV, 9 Eastern time on ESPN, also available in ESPN HD. Seventh tie of this ball game. There have been 6 lead changes. You're right, Bob. It doesn't look like either team is going to be able to put together enough of a spurt to shake the other. Ramon with a shot clock running out.
Your defense, nothing will.
Tough pass, Hawes, with a great catch by Brockman, and he scores.
What a response, huh? That is poise by Washington.
Ramon, who has the last 5 points for Pittsburgh, guarded by Appleby. And out of five. Oliver all over Cook. Third foul on Oliver. Fifth on the team and a timeout.
Innovative solutions from Siemens can be found everywhere. By helping to make water more pure, buildings more efficient, facilities more modern, communications better integrated, and energy more reliable, we're turning dreams into reality.
The fastest game on 2 feet.
With 1 second left.
The shots.
Pulls a trigger. He scores!
The saves.
Tremendous save.
The fast breaks.
Here comes the All-American.
The home of men's college lacrosse, ESPNU. The best in the game all season long. National powerhouse Duke returns to action at home against Dartmouth.
What a goal! A thing of beauty!
Next Saturday at 2, only on ESPNU, the premier destination for men's lacrosse.
This is your home. This is your business. This is your home phone and computer. This is your business phone and computer. You pay $29.95 each for home phone and internet service. You pay $29.95 each for business. When you get the Optimum Double Play, get the most reliable internet access with Optimum Online and experience speeds 5 times faster than DSL. With Optimum Voice, you'll get unlimited calling in the U.S., Canada, and Puerto Rico. Better internet access and better telephone service for one flat rate of $29.95 a month each. With Optimum Double Play for home, you'll start saving your first year. With Optimum Double Play for business, you'll save even more your first year with no contracts or hidden fees. And switching is risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. So remember, this is your home, this is your business, and this is what you'll pay with Optimum, just $29.95 per month each. Call 1-877-778-FAST to get the better choice, the Optimum Double Play. Millions are already saving at home and work. You can too. Call now.
Go. Marino goes deep.
And welcome back to the campus of the University of Pittsburgh. Among those in attendance, Dave Wanstead. Good job recruiting his first couple of years as coach at Pitt. Now the Native's getting a little restless to see more wins.
Let's go, Pitt! Let's go, Pitt! Let's go, Pitt! Let's go, Pitt!
Antonio Graves now for Pittsburgh, leading by one, under 7 minutes to go. Ramon with Young, Cook, and Gray. The rest of the fivesome out there for Jamie Dixon.
Look at how crowded it is in the lane. Look at all those purple jerseys around Gray.
And he gets fouled. Gray has only 2 points on 1 out of 6 from the floor. He does have 8 rebounds.
He has drawn this kind of attention, and that's why those numbers are so low. 3 guys all around him, 5 guys in the paint. Gray goes to the line where he is an adventure. Only 57% on the year.
Now Oliver, the second Husky with 4 fouls. They're not a deep team. Pondexter and Oliver now with 4 each. This free throw would give him 1,000 for his career. And it rattles up. Is it 999? Is Brockman rebounded the miss? Washington outscored by 9 points from the line in this game, down by 2 overall.
This is going to be possession for possession.
Brockman threw it away, did a good job the rest of a bad pass, but then made a bad play after he did. And Pittsburgh trying to return the favor, kept possession. Cook hands it off to Young. 10 for Sam Young, his career high, 21. Week and a half ago in their win at West Virginia.
They love him here.
Appleby steps back into a three.
The value of the three-point shot. Stuns the crowd, gets you right back in games.
11 for Appleby. The average is 9.5 per game. Timeout, Pittsburgh. They lead by 1 despite shooting 34%. That's counteracted by Washington, 16 turnovers. Appleby has made at least 1 3 in 25 straight games now for UW. Back within 1.
Listings to choose from on cars.com. You can find the right car for you.
That's it.
Find the right car for you. Cars.com.
They say family that plays together stays together. And one that walks apart just falls apart. So together we stand, divided we fall. United we form Voltron and take on all. Let's move. Second coming.
Playing in the Super Bowl isn't enough for Matt Hasselbeck. He hungers for more.
Like new Campbell's Chunky Barbecue Burger Soup.
Feed your NFL-sized hunger. Campbell's Chunky. Meals that fill you up right. Presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Cars.com. Find the right car for you. Cars.com.
Back in Pittsburgh, where the Panthers have a 1-point lead over Washington, the Huskies in dire need of a signature win. Really, a couple of big wins on their way to the end of the regular season, and as we mentioned at the top of the telecast, great opportunities upcoming, including today and 3 other games when they return to the conference schedule. The last 4 games of the regular season, 3 ranked opponents, Oregon, USC, and UCLA, still ahead. Pittsburgh, the ball, a 1-point lead, 24 seconds to shoot.
In addition to all those games, they have the Pac-10 tournament, which is entering its 6th year at the Staples Center.
Gray has 3 points. Hawes has 6 points. They've combined on 4 out of 18 shooting. Ramon, another elbow jumper. He has 9. He's been terrific here in the second half.
Great screen by Gray. He's not scoring, but he is rebounding, trying to free his teammates.
Oliver playing with four fouls. Hawes is 3 out of 12 from the floor.
He's being pushed way out of his area.
As a result, he takes what was nearly a three with Gray lunging out at him. Spencer Hawes, 8 points, 10 rebounds, and the Huskies back within a point.
Hawes not able to score inside in this game. His natural tendency to drift to the perimeter a little.
Fields with Ramon, Gray, Young, and Cook.
Weak side help always there when Gray is posting up.
Fields for three. It's in and out and back in again. And a timeout by Jamie Dixon. Hopping up
smile.
And down. He knows he was probably a little more animated than he needed to be to get Mike Kitz's attention. They're 4 out of 14 from beyond the arc today. Again, not a real great day shooting the three ball for the best three-point shooting team in the Big East.
Well, this is a very, very difficult shot. It is contested well by Dentman. Levance feels fading away. It hit every part of the iron. That was a tough, tough shot.
Jamie
Ooh, that
Dixon.
Was
tough. bouncing up and down to get the timeout. I think he realizes I didn't really need to be halfway out on the court and jumping up and down like that. Mike Kitz, I'm still talking to Mike Kitz about it. Jamie Dixon, like Lorenzo Romar, native of Southern California. Jamie's 41 years old. When he gets to 100 wins, and he hopes he'll need only one more to get there after today, he'll be one of the fastest in the history of college basketball ever to get to 100 wins. At 98-26 right now in his fourth season as head coach at Pitt.
First year coach, and he wins 31 games. Pretty amazing stuff. What great 3 years it has been, huh?
Yep.
And Washington's been very good last 3 years as well. Twice to the Sweet 16.
And the best stretches in the history of these two programs. The big step now for Pittsburgh will be to get past the Sweet 16.
Right.
A lot of regular season success. Regular trips to the Big East championship game in the conference tournament. But they haven't been able to get as far as many thought they could. In the NCAA tournament, Brockman fouled. He'll go to the line after a timeout. Foul on Gray, his third.
All right, customer service. Well, there's Sally. She's your new customer, and she worries. But if you ship her order with UPS, it'll email her. Hey, Sally, I'm leaving the warehouse. Now it notifies her. Hey, Sally, took a left in Louisville. Now it writes, hey, I'm right downstairs. Look, Sally's smiling. It's not customer service. It's your customer service. With UPS.
When my brother started selling auto insurance, I got a little pressure to use them.
A little? I'm State Farm Agent Amy Kaplan, and this is a true story.
I didn't pressure you. I think blood is thicker than water.
So is some of his staff. We switched from State Farm to him.
The service was horrible.
Well, he wouldn't call me back, and he's my brother.
So I called him, and he was ready to switch back. State Farm treated us like family.
Yeah, better.
Great service and great rates, it's all here. Nobody takes care of you like State Farm. Call an agent today.
Like a good neighbor?
State Farm is there.
How much do you pay when you buy a stock? Does the rate change depending on how often you trade or how much you have in your account? At TD Ameritrade, there's only one price for online stock trades, $9.99. No matter how often you trade, no matter how much money you have in your account. Straightforward pricing from TD Ameritrade. Independence is the spirit that drives America's most successful investors.
It's going to take a miracle to sink this putt. 60 feet away with a quick break for... Hey, what's he doing?
Looks like somebody missed snack time.
Get back to your senses with McDonald's new Honey Mustard Snack Wrap. The tender, all-white chicken breast meat now comes grilled and topped with a sweet and sassy honey mustard sauce. Try it for $1.29.
Can he do that?
Yes!
Oklahoma State, the 17-game home win streak on the line, and it might make their tourney candidacy a little more tenuous. Keon Lawrence hitting there. Missouri pulls out the win in Stillwater by 11. DJ White and the Hoosiers, 11 straight wins against Michigan. Wolverines desperately need this one. It's coming up next here on ESPN.
A lot of desperate teams at this time of the year. Washington, one of them as well. Trailing by four, just under 4 minutes to go here in Pittsburgh at the beautiful Peterson Event Center. The Washington people, when they came out into the building today, marveling at what a nice facility this is.
They're building much, much older, the Heck Edmondson Center.
Brockman's first free throw of the game is a miss. He's 65%. One out of two. They're within 3 points. Brockman's sister Kirsten played on the women's team at the University of Washington a few years ago. He wears the number 40 because that's the number she wore.
Nice family tree. Pittsburgh is very good at possession for possession basketball. They use the clock well and they use get something quality.
Young has it rattle out. Hawes the rebound. His 11th board of the ball game. A three ball would tie it now for the University of Washington. 3.5 minutes to go. Denman guarded by Fields. Now Brockman with Gray on him. Oliver watched by Cook. 10 to shoot. Hawes over Young, and it's a one-point game. 10 points for Hawes. His dad likes it. A double-double now for Spencer.
Big-time shot. He had a smaller guy on him, and they found him near the end of the shot clock. Intelligent play by Washington.
Fields to Ramon with Young, Gray, and Cook. Gray, Hawes a little slow getting over. He looked tired there as he tried to rally to Gray on defense. That's 1,001 career points. He goes over 1,000. 34th Pittsburgh player in the history of the program to reach the 1,000-point milestone.
And he did it mostly in his junior and senior year. Freshman and sophomore didn't play too much.
Brockman, one-on-one with Young. And it rolls off to Gray. Good rebound in traffic. Of course, he takes up a lot of space in traffic. Ninth rebound for Gray. But only 3 points. He will not have his 31st career double-double tonight in all likelihood. Cook got a handout and shoved Oliver for an offensive foul. Third foul on Cook. No reason to do that. And that was as clear as it could be. He just took his right arm and shoved Oliver away.
Pretty obvious.
7th team foul in Pittsburgh. Timeout Washington. Third personal on Cook. Here's the milestone. They're just announcing it to the crowd now during the timeout. Aaron Gray. Career points 1,000 and 1,001 for the senior 7-footer from Emmaus, Pennsylvania. Short as 2 seasons ago as a sophomore, playing behind Chris Tappy, averaging only 4.3 points per game. That happens a lot here at Pittsburgh. They tend to have players who stay 4 years. They don't have anybody in the NBA right now. So players have to wait their turn.
And they wait, and they do well when they get their turn, don't they?
Remind you again tonight, great matchup, battle for first place in the ACC. Fourth-ranked North Carolina in beautiful Chestnut Hill to take on the Boston College Eagles. Coverage begins with College Game Day, driven by State Farm at 8 Eastern. Reese, Hubert, Digger, and Jay, our game day crew on hand. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV on ESPN. The ball game at 9 Eastern time, also available in ESPN HD. Huskies down 3. Hawes, unlucky, it popped out to Fields, and he's fouled by Dentman. the second on Denman, and that will send them to the other end. Both teams in the bonus now, each with 17 fouls.
LaVance Fields not only is a good free throw shooter at 72, but he is also mentally tough, likes these kinds of situations.
6 for 6 from the line, all those in the first half. 77% for the season.
Does what's needed for his team.
Sure does. Best assist to turnover ratio in Pitt history for his career. 2.35 assists for every turnover. That's a remarkable number about this Pittsburgh team. They have the 9-man rotation. 8 of the 9 for the season have more assists than turnovers. Only Sam Young has more turnovers than assists.
That's a pretty remarkable stat when you think about it, because most of the time, you know, you get a 2-to-1 assist to turnover ratio. That's fantastic, and he's way above that. And as a team, they handle the ball very well.
The lead 5. Time running out on the Huskies. 1.5 to go. Oliver threw it off the side of the backboard. It comes to Hawes with the left. He scores. 12 points for Spencer Hawes.
He has skill, doesn't he?
Mm-hmm.
He's used his left hand better than his right hand in this game.
If they can get it to him here in the final minute plus. The other night against Washington State in that narrow home loss, Hawes did not take a shot over the last 5.5 minutes of the game.
That's a mistake.
Good defense by LeCoug, certainly a part of that. Under a minute to go now. Down to 10 to shoot for Pittsburgh, trying to build on a 3-point lead. Fields, a tough fadeaway that rolls out. Young tipped it. Young has it with help from Gray. New shot clock for Pittsburgh. Only a 10-second difference between the game clock, which you see, and the shot clock.
The reason that happened is Hawes switched out, so he was not underneath to get the rebound.
They don't want to foul Ramon, and they do. One of the best free throw shooters in the country, Ronald Ramon, will go to the line.
Notice Hawes on the outside as a result. Brockman in there rebounding, but the other guy's smallish. And Young comes up with it. Good hustle by the Panthers. That's one of the problems of switching defenses on the perimeter. Your big guys get caught guarding little guys. The shot goes up and you don't have your normal rebounding responsibilities.
Husky timeout, each team with 2 left. Both teams in the bonus, 1-1. Foul on Appleby, his 3rd. And Ramon will be at the free throw line for a 1-1 opportunity. He's 2 for 2 from the line today. In a week of upsets, including the result in Nashville today, Vanderbilt ending Florida's winning streak. North Carolina loser it against Virginia Tech. Roy Williams blamed himself for that loss. Didn't like the way he managed the bench. Pittsburgh here Monday night to Louisville. A&M, that was an important win for Texas Tech with an eye toward the NCAA tournament. Marquette a loser at DePaul.
Marquette's in the tournament no matter what right now. They've got 21 wins, so that doesn't hurt them at all. You know, sometimes in these games, if you're a league commissioner, you're wanting the lesser team in the league to win. You know, Georgetown beats Villanova today. Might have been better for Villanova to beat Georgetown in terms of the numbers of teams that you might qualify for the NCAAs.
There's Ramon. 86% for the year coming in. 2 out of 2 today. Now 3 out of 3. 10 points. Just a little bit better than his average of 9 per game. I think Villanova's in no matter what, though. Their RPI entering today 14 or 15.
They played a very, very tough schedule, and the win against Texas and at Oklahoma are going to be very important for their resume.
Huskies have to hurry. Been a very solid performance on the road, but in their situation with an eye toward the NCAA tournament, close is not going to be good enough. Trying to drive. Kicks it out to Appleby for 3. 12 seconds to go. Gray knocked to the deck by Brockman and grabbing his left shin.
Gray's mother's parents. Reaction, huh? Yeah. He looks like he's got a knot right on his shin. Jamie Dixon asking if there was a foul on the play. Action when the ball is in the air. Very, very physical game.
Fields is also slow to get up. He got hit in the knee by the falling Gray. Gray limps off. And the good news for his family and everyone else, he does not look to be in excruciating pain. Remember, you could see him tell the Huskies who were inquiring on his way to the huddle that he's all right. Mom seems concerned, but I think she'll be relieved later on because it doesn't look to be that serious. It doesn't look like he's coming out of the game. Although it might be wise to put a different free throw shooter in there. He is going to limp off now. They did this the other night against Providence. You remember that, Bob. And Tim Welsh didn't like it because Gray came right back in after somebody shot the free throws for him.
You can put your best free throw shooter in, which is going to happen. Graves, excellent from there.
It just looks like he cut his shin. I don't think it's an ankle injury. No trainers even around Gray, so that does not appear to be serious. Antonio Graves, the stand-in, misses. The time is running out on the Huskies, perhaps on their NCAA tournament hopes as well. Dentman scores with 3.5 to go. Timeout Washington. Down by 3.5 seconds remaining and one timeout left for Lorenzo Romar. He wants a full timeout. We mentioned they were picked to finish third in the media poll in the Pac-10. They're not going to get anywhere near that, and it was probably unrealistic given the youth. But the reality now is it looks like he and his staff, Cameron Dollar, Paul Fortier, Jim Shaw, are building a program that's going to be a factor every year because they are continuing to get some of the most highly touted recruits in the country. That hasn't happened at Pitt. They've done a great job of winning a huge number of games without the blue chip recruits.
Yes, indeed. That's outlined very, very well. And Gray is one of those guys who was not that highly recruited. And there you look at Pitt. Pretty terrific stuff. You talked about them wanting to get past the Sweet 16.
They're likely to be a two seed, as you said, Bob, if it were today. Still an outside shot at number one, and they'll have time to boost their resume. We mentioned earlier they are tied with Georgetown after Georgetown's win over Villanova today for the top of the Big East, and they have wins. They have games left at Georgetown and at Marquette. Well, let's throw it to Dave Barnett while we have a break in the action here. Dave?
D.J. Wyatt and Indiana are playing a stretch of 4 out of 5 on the road, including today at sold-out Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor, where Deion Harris and Michigan hope to end an 11-game series losing streak to the Hoosiers. Right now, let's send it back to Sean McDonough.
Washington trying to end an even longer streak. 31 losses in a row on the road against top 10 opponents. Doesn't look like it's going to happen. They need a quick steal and a three-point field goal or quick foul. A miss at the Pittsburgh free throw line and then another prayer. In the Cook. Oliver fouls him. 2.9 left. And that's 5 fouls on Oliver. He leaves with 8 points.
Well, obviously, making free throws here will seal the deal. A miss will leave the door wide open. I'll tell you what, Lorenzo Romar's team, if you didn't know what their record was and you just watched them play out here on the floor, you'd say this was a pretty impressive team.
Yeah, I think they are good. Just really hurt for that month that Hawes was sick. And when you start 1-6 in your league, with your best player being well off his game, and you're not deep, that really hurts, and they are not going to be able to recover from that, it seems, unless they can pull off some upsets in the remaining schedule that yields opportunity. But the reality is, given their RPI, they're going to need to win more than one of those games against the 3 ranked teams they have left.
Yeah. Well, the Oregon trip might be beneficial for them right now. Oregon, even though highly ranked, is not playing well. However, the 2 games against USC and UCLA are going to be very tough. They are at home, however, where they're 15-2.
That should do it. A 4-point lead now, 2.9 to go. Cooks had a very nice game, 15 points. Jamie Dixon wants his players out of the lane. second rolls off to Brockman. Gentman a heave. Here it goes. Pittsburgh is victorious. So the Panthers bounce back after the rare home loss on Monday to Louisville. They go to 23-4 overall. Final score, 65-61 over Washington. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Bob Wenza, Sean McDonough, so long from Pittsburgh. Here's Dave Redson.
Thank you, Sean. Michigan hasn't beaten Indiana since January of 2001. Deion Harris and company going to try to change that. Big game for the Wolverines coming up next.
Think your business communications aren't this outdated? If your Long Island business is relying on the phone company, you're probably depending on copper wire, the same technology they used 100 years ago. Switch to Metro Ethernet from Optimum LightPath and upgrade your voice, data, and internet services to our 100% fully fiber optic network. You'll get proven reliability, maximum bandwidth, and monthly savings of up to 50% over the phone company, all guaranteed. Stop wasting time and money dealing with old technology. Upgrade your business with Metro Ethernet from Optimum LightPath today, and we'll make the switch easier than ever. We'll connect you to our 100% fully fiber optic network for free. Plus, you'll get a credit on your first full month of service, a free managed router, and free installation. Hurry, switch now before this offer becomes outdated. Call 1-877-LIGHTPATH or visit metroethernetnow.com today.
Second sellout of the year at Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. 13,751, including, of course, the Maze Rage. As college basketball presented by Cars.com brings you Big Ten action today. Number 19, Indiana, taking on a team they've beaten 11 straight times, the Michigan Wolverines. The Big Ten still led by Wisconsin and Ohio State, and with Florida's loss earlier today at Vanderbilt, those may be the top two teams in the country in the next poll. Indiana third by itself. Michigan tries to get to 500 in league play. As we welcome you to Ann Arbor, Dave Barnett along with Steve Bardo. Indiana at this point playing for seeding, looking ahead to the tournament, and Michigan still without that common phrase this year in college basketball, the signature win. Can they get it today?
Well, they really need to, Dave, because their only signature win, so to speak, is Davidson outside of the Big Ten Conference. So very important for them to get a big-time win against a ranked opponent within Big Ten play.
Our Star Watch today featuring big man and for Indiana, DJ White. As he goes, they go, leading score, rebounder, shot blocker, and field goal percentage man. And for the second straight year, Courtney Sims leads the entire Big Ten in field goal percentage, but comes off the bench today. As both coaches, Tommy Amaker and Kelvin Sampson, shake things up a little bit with Armand Bassett coming off his impressive start to his freshman year and 16 points against Purdue. Wilmont Sewer getting a start. White getting his second start. Harris, Smith, Abram, Petway, and Udo with Sims today coming off the bench. And the Wolverines control the tap. Donnie Gray, Paul Jansen, and Eric Curry are our officials.
Well, when Michigan's rolling, Deion Harris mixes his game up very well with penetration and those outside jumpers.
On the baseline for Michigan, Air Georgia, Brent Petway making his move on DJ White, and some bad luck off the glass.
If you're Coach Amaker, you like that shot, though. Petway took his time, got to a sweet spot, and that's attacking the glass.
Indiana perfect at home this year, 13-0. Far from it on the road, 2-6 on opponents' home floors. They are 2-1 on neutral courts.
Oh, looked like DJ got away with a Texas two-step along the baseline.
Bassett's pass too tall for Mike White. Kelvin Sampson in his first year in Bloomington. 17-7 start, best since a first-year Hoosier coach since Bob Knight's first year, 71-72. And the best start in Big Ten play since Branch McCracken in 38-39.
Well, you know Kelvin Sampson's teams are going to be hard-nosed. They're going to hit the glass extremely well, and they're going to pressure the ball.
Harris tried to thread down to the baseline to Abram. Tommy Amaker in his sixth year in Ann Arbor has averaged 17 wins. None of them, however, have come against the Hoosiers.
And Tommy Amaker was a pretty good player at Duke and looks like he could still get it done on the floor if he has to.
Eric Sewer out front, the senior from Bloomington. Just his third start. Bassett out of Terre Haute and Hargrave Military Academy. Always produces a ton of Division I talent. Big block as White goes baseline against Petway and regrets it. Petway fourth in the Big Ten in shot blocking.
You can see Michigan's come out with a lot of intensity thus far, especially on the defensive end.
Harris with room for the three.
Well, that's bad news for Indiana right there. Harris takes half of his attempts from three-point land, so he gets it going early. He can heat up quickly.
Indiana moves it around well. Sewer, though, cut off. And they work it inside for White. Off-balance hook.
Well, for Indiana fans, that's a beautiful sight to see is the big fella healthy this year, finally. Got his strength back and taking his time in the post.
Michigan powering inside. Efe Udo, freshman from Edmond, Oklahoma.
He's a good-looking freshman, too. Takes what the defense gives him, goes strong to the bucket. He could throw some shots out of there as well.
Second leading shot blocker in the Big Ten. Michigan leads the Big Ten in shot blocking. They have three of the top six individuals, including Petway, who's already got two.
Well, look at the first block here. Petway comes out of nowhere. And then that's just a volleyball spike right there.
So the chant Air Georgia starts up. Bassett missed the three from the corner. Roderick Wilmot unable to chase it down. With some already intimidating interior defense by the Wolverines.
They want to establish that inside, and Indiana is best when DJ White is doing his thing in the post and he's able to kick out to the shooters. Michigan ideally would like to shut one of those aspects of the game down. It looks like they're making it tough on DJ White early.
Petway operating low, barely any iron. Good defense by DJ White, the junior from Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Kelvin Sampson talking him out of joining Robert Vaden, following Mike Davis from IU to UAB. As Sampson took over in Bloomington. After 12 years at Oklahoma, 11 of which ended an NCAA tournament bid. Tommy Amaker trying to get to the NCAA tournament. Last year, 22 wins and an NIT finals appearance for the second time in 3 years. So they're done with that. NIT,
right.
Seen it, done it, time to move on.
Time to move on.
His program's concerned.
And time to have his senior step up and take some leadership and play with some urgency down the stretch. We talked to him before the game, and he says, I think they're starting to understand what it takes.
Armand Bassett. Ball for the offensive foul with the elbow. Earl Calloway, we don't expect to see today. Injured his shoulder. And they listed him as doubtful, but not including him in the starting lineup. They said probably means he won't get off the bench either. Smith turns, fires into three. It's 16 for the year.
Well, Michigan's really getting anything they want on the offensive end. Indiana a little flat coming out, which I'm sure Kelvin will have something to say about. But on this end, Indiana not very fluid offensively, really missing Calloway, getting them into their sets.
Harris doubling down against White, who lost it out of bounds. 15-26, a good start for the Wolverines. They lead 8-2.
The NCAA women. Women's Basketball Championship coming in March.
I've been to Newark, Hackensack, three meetings back to back.
Conference in Maine, put faces to names.
Seminar, Lombard, big stack of business cards.
Stayed at Comfort Suites, got a hot breakfast free.
Warehouse inventory, foreman had a funny story.
Big meeting, New Rochelle, told my boss all went well.
This spring, stay at any Comfort Inn, Comfort Suites, Quality Inn, Sleep Inn, or Clarion Hotel. You'll earn triple choice privileges points or triple airline rewards with your second stay. For reservations, visit choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there. You are an
obsession. Large bucket. $10. Another large bucket. $10. Another large bucket. $10.
Honey, why are you hitting the card guy?
Practice, practice, practice.
Get there.
Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For the obsessive golfer, there's MasterCard.
It's going to take a miracle to sink this putt. 60 feet away with a quick break for... Hey, what's he doing?
Looks like somebody missed snack time.
Get back to your senses with McDonald's new Honey Mustard Snack Wrap. The tender, all-white chicken breast meat now comes grilled and topped with a sweet and sassy honey mustard sauce. Try it for $1.29.
Can he do that?
Yes!
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Cars.com. Find the right car for you. Cars.com. And in part by ChunkyFan.com, where football and large chunks of meat meet.
An inspired start by the Michigan Wolverines. Indiana scores on only one of its first six possessions, and Michigan on top 8-2. So Michigan is 17-9, 5-6 in the Big Ten. That's tied for seventh. They've lost five of their last six. Schedule strength, RPI, not that impressive.
Yeah, and you look at the board right there, and you look at what they have remaining at Illinois, at Minnesota, Michigan State, and Ohio State. So Michigan has their work cut out for them. And as you mentioned earlier, Dave, they've done enough NIT. They want the real dance now. They want the big-time dance.
That's what Tommy Amaker was brought here to bring about. Looks for his first NCAA appearance in his sixth year after 4 years at Seton Hall. Period highlighted by a trip to the Sweet 16 in 2000. Garrett Smith, sophomore, Romulus, Michigan. Harris has it poked away by A.J. Ratliff in off the bench. And Smith left alone up top, missed the three.
Oh, looks like they got D.J. White.
Much to his surprise, his first. DJ White, the third leading rebounder in the conference, so he's used to getting any board he wants with that kind of position carved out inside.
It looked like he got his hand on Abram as he was going up for the rebound, almost like a reactionary type thing. And we've seen a lot more contact than that this early.
Deion Harris with his second three-pointer. Second all-time here, that's 249. In his career, and that's a timeout for Kelvin Sampson. 14-52 in the first half, one of the best starts all year by the Wolverines.
We did it for the clutch players. New beds, new lobbies, courtyards changed it all for the go-to guys. Deeper mattresses, crisper sheets, wider open spaces with Wi-Fi, easy chairs, and freshly stocked 24-hour markets. All new, all for the players who suit up and take the field.
Courtyard, redesigned by business travelers for business travelers.
Go team.
An 8-0 run by Michigan. 4 of 7 from the field and 3 of 4 on three-pointers, which is not their strong suit, to say the least. They're next to last in three-point baskets in the Big Ten. But Indiana only 1 of 4 from the field, and they've turned it over three times, Steve.
It's almost like the perfect storm for Michigan today, where you knew they were going to play hard at home against Indiana, but Earl Callaway has really affected the way that Indiana has, or their inability to get it to their offense.
A.J. Ratliff misses the three. Long rebound. Seward dives for it and touched it last. Well, even Indiana hustle not paying off so far.
Well, looked like Ratliff had a pretty good look from three, but again, they would prefer to start with DJ White and let him get going early and then possibly force a double team to open up some opportunities.
First meeting started off just the opposite, all Hoosiers. Donnie Gray with the foul on Sewer. His first. Eric Sewer maybe was the Hoosier who took Mike Davis's departure the hardest. But Kelvin Sampson rewarding him for staying in the program on scholarship now, former walk-on from Bloomington.
Eric Sewer is the biggest clown on the team and keeps these guys loose when necessary. So you don't always notice his impact on the squad.
And Deion Harris draws a foul. College basketball continues this evening with two more games on ESPN and ESPN2. First, 6 Eastern, ESPN has the matchup between number 9 Memphis and Gonzaga out at Spokane. And then at 6 Eastern, ESPN2 with Northern Iowa and number 10 Nevada. College basketball and the O'Reilly ESPNU Bracket Busters on ESPN and ESPN2 later today.
Before Josh Heifetz got suspended, and when Gonzaga was rolling, that Gonzaga-Memphis game was going to be a doozy, but the Bulldogs are going to have a tough time staying up with Calipari's bunch.
Courtney Sims now in off the bench, and Indiana taking it away. Second Michigan turnover. Trying to get something in transition. Not a bad idea the way Michigan has started this game defensively, and Roderick Wilmot sends in a three.
Now, Eric Sewer set that up. He came in and pump fake, act like he was going to the hole to shoot, pulling defense away from Wilmot.
The alley-oop intended for Brent Petway, and he got pushed out of bounds by Lance Stimler. Who's just in for the first time. Junior from Columbia, Illinois. Fourth team foul on the Hoosiers.
Stimler trying to come back from a left ankle injury. Very valuable to this team with his size at 6'8". Can shoot the rock outside, but can guard power forwards as well. So very valuable for the Hoosier squad.
Got hurt in practice on Tuesday. Driving into traffic, offensive foul, Jared Smith.
There you go, Lance Stimler giving up his body defensively. See here, right there, holds his ground. Very smart play defensively to shut that driving lane down at the last second.
Michigan plays almost the first 7 minutes without a foul. And their first one takes away a good finish by Smith. Now down the baseline, Wilmot. Quickly, the Wolverines pick up their second.
Boy, that's a nice set play to get Roderick Wilmot on the block. As soon as he caught it, there was no hesitation going baseline.
Ron Coleman putting Wilmot on the line. Senior from Miramar, Florida, has shown across-the-board improvement every year. Fifth-year senior. Again, his best defender, probably the most athletic player.
When you look at him, Dave, you can tell he knows where the weight room is because he wasn't that size when he came to Bloomington.
Now they list him 6'4", 203. He's up quite a bit in the strength department from 4 years ago. Harris. Indiana starting to close down both boards. Wilmot pulls that one down. Eric Sewer well beyond the arc, nails the three.
And he got hit on the shot. Didn't bother him, though, and here comes the Hoosiers.
Seven unanswered for Indiana. Sims puts it into it. 61% from the field. Second straight year, he leads the Big Ten in field goal percentage.
And from that shot, you can see why, Dave. That was degree of difficulty, 9.9 on that. Fading away, took the bump, and still got the roll.
Yep, not just layups and dunks for him. White turns and swishes the hook. Second basket for DJ.
Well, I like to see two big men go at it, mano-a-mano on the block. DJ White didn't like that too much, so he gave him some of his own medicine.
Harris been looking for Petway. Stemler leaves him in the alley-oop from Smith. Petway unable to hammer that one down, and the timeout with 11:34 remaining. Sims off the bench to help keep Michigan on top.
Bye, hon. Find us a good one.
Bye.
With 2 million vehicle listings to choose from on Cars.com, you can find the right car for you.
There it is.
Find the right car for you. Cars.com.
GE, we're combining imagination with advanced technology around the world to make it a better place to live for everyone. GE, imagination at work.
There's a place where simple food like chicken is now simply extraordinary. Introducing Chicken Fresco, Portobello, and Oscar. Our freshest, tastiest chicken ever. Ruby Tuesday.
Wolverines by two here midway in the first half. The top two teams in the ACC hit the hardwood tonight in a battle for first place. Game day was there at the Conti Forum about 10 hours before tip-off, and they already had about a half-full crowd with their version of the Maze Rage there. So emotion will not be lacking at BC tonight as Carolina comes in.
No, especially because of that shellacking they received on the hands of Duke earlier in the week and trying to stay in the first-place race in ACC. But Jared Dudley should be the leading candidate for ACC Player of the Year. Kept that team in first place despite losing Sean Williams to suspension early in conference play.
Hoosiers have yet to lead today. They fell down early 11-2. They had a 7-0 run ended a moment ago by Courtney Sims. Now Harris following Seward.
This is where Michigan got their jump start at the beginning of the game. Pressure defense trying to keep Indiana out of their sets, and they had relaxed.